Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, we're taking a closer look at the new weather filter in On1 Photo RAW. If you haven't seen the weather filter, it's a new release in On1 Photo RAW 2020. Now, I'm going to start this review with a disclaimer. Whilst I'm a big fan of On1 Photo RAW and upgraded immediately to the 2020 version, I absolutely hate simulated weather effects. But before I explain why I hate these effects so much, I'll start by explaining how to use the filter. To help, I've created this image, which is totally black. This is to help you see the effect of the controls more clearly. I'll start by adding a new weather filter. At the top of the filter, we have three styles that allow you to quickly apply creative weather effects. There's also a drop-down list with a couple of additional effects, as well as the ability to save a new style. When I click the foghorn effect, you can see the effect of the fog against the black background. Notice that this gives a fog effect at the top, and below this is a stronger, slightly lighter band. After that, it transitions to being clear and you can see the black again. In the filter, the controls are arranged into three sections, which you can use to apply the adjustments. In the top section, we've got the precipitation controls, and these relate to the rain and snow effects. Next, there's transform, and this controls the scale and orientation of the effect on the image. And at the bottom, we have the fog section to control the fog effects. If I move the amount slider left and right, you can see the strength of the effect is adjusted. Moving the distance slider moves the effect up and down. This allows you to better position and align the effect with your image. The rotation slider allows you to then rotate the angle of the fog as well. You can also use this position drop-down. And this contains different presets to allow you to control the effects without using the other two sliders, the distance and the rotation. The final slider here is transition, and this controls the transition zone between the clear area here where it's black and the fog effect here. And if I move this over to the right, you can see the transition gets much larger. Move it to the left and the effect becomes much harder. If I move it to zero, you can see we've got just a hard line. Now let's change the weather style from foghorn to blizzard. In this style, we've got a combination of fog, controlled by the fog section at the bottom, and also the precipitation, which is controlled in the top section. We can use the controls in the precipitation section to refine the effect. Here we can use the opacity slider to either reduce the effect and make it more transparent, or we can increase it and make the snowflakes more obvious. We can also change the type of precipitation using this drop-down list. Here we've got alpine, or maybe we want one of the rain effects instead. Now that you know how the filter works, let's see how it performs using an actual image. This first image is a simple sunset I shot recently in the Lake District. Let's apply a weather filter. And we'll apply the foghorn adjustment. As you can see, the result isn't exactly believable. The same happens if I select the blizzard filter or the Seattle rain filter. This illustrates one of the reasons why I don't like weather simulation filters. Most of the images that people create with these don't appear believable. This is partly because the weather we're trying to simulate doesn't match the lighting conditions in the image. Now, if we change the style to something a little different, so let's use sticking, what we find is something that is actually a little bit more believable. It could really be snowing at sunset. But there is another problem with this effect, I clearly shot the image using a wide-angle lens, but look at the snowflakes here. They shot with a different focal length. Now there is a scale option here, but it only makes the problem worse. Let's then try the filter on a different image that may suit it a little bit more. In this image, we already have weather conditions that are foggy and frosty. Now when I apply the foghorn style, we create a more believable effect. We can also refine this effect to make it more believable using a luminosity mask. Combining the filter with a mask is a good idea. It prevents the effect from being uniform across the entire image, and that makes it much more believable. Now let's add a second weather filter to the image to simulate snow, rather than trying to apply both snow and fog together. And as before, we can refine this by applying a mask to remove the snow from the sky. If you compare this to the starting image, you can see that the new adjustment actually appears quite realistic, although it has lightened the entire image quite a lot. I would say that the filter is a useful addition, providing you use it with care. Don't expect it to convert any image and create a realistic and believable effect. It doesn't work like that. It's much better when you are enhancing an image that already has that type of weather effect. But you also need to apply it in a way that keeps the effect realistic. Don't have a uniform adjustment across the entire image. That is unless you're trying to create a highly stylized image. But I'll save that for another video. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.